there are two moments that are key for the process of creating Blancanieves. One was in the early 90s, even before, in the mid 80s, when I saw for the first time a silent film with a live orchestra. It was Greed of Eric von Stroheim with music of Carl Davis, and it was at the San Sebastian Film Festival. And at that moment, I kind of realized, I want to make a silent film, but I had to figure out script. I needed a script for this film. So later on, I found this book of photographs, and there was a photo of bullfighting dwarfs. And this photo kind of like talked to me, and I imagined, what if I put in the middle of this photo Snow White? So I had the poster, I had the idea of making a black and white film, silent, so I just had to write the script. And the script I had already in 2005. So it's been a long way. It's been cooking slowly, Blancanieves. It took me a long time to finance the film. You know, I showed the producers the script in 2005, and it took me 8 years to get the finance together. So in that time, there was a moment that I had to create the storyboard. So with a good friend of mine that he's a storyboard artist, we sat to, you know, it was around 6 months, but it took us like, in a period of 2 years, we kind of worked 1 month at a time, and we ended with a storyboard of as thick as a phone book. And so when the movie got financed and we started the pre-production of the film, we already had the storyboards. So in that sense, that visual element to tell the story with images, you know, it was there. Although when you get on the set, nothing is what you plan, nothing is what you ask for, so you have to improvise a lot. But it's much easier to improvise when you have a plan than improvise without any plan. To make a film is just an achievement, it's a success. It could take you 2 years, it could take you 20. In my case, for all my feature film, every film took me a long time. You know, Torremolino 73, my first feature film, took me 6 years. Blancanieves has taken me 8 years. But, you know, I think time, every film requires a different time. Definitely there are exceptions. We all know, like, you know, Orson Welles made Citizen Kane when he was 23, or Amenábar in Spain made his first film when he was 24, 23. But, you know, normally the career of a director is long, and a film takes a long time. And I even would kind of repeat like a Japanese say. In Japan they say that if you're in a hurry, you should take the long way. And I think in filmmaking, normally that's the right way to go. You know, it's not about how many films you make. It's about how many films they are like your dream, and how many, and you are like honest about your work. And in my case, my film are like my children. They are like children that they are desire. It's not like they're not imposed. They just, I wanted to make these films. And in the case of Blancanieves, it was 8 years. And I can assure you that it was worth it. Definitely, my hair got white from the beginning, but I still have the same, you know, joy of making films. And I still haven't lost any moment of romanticism. For me, like, it's a gift, and I'm very fortunate to be a film director. I think it's way safe to say not talking or non-dialogue, because definitely there, you tell the story with images, and that's the element what attracts me about silent movies. You know, and that's actually what cinema's about. Not even like silent movies or talking movies. Cinema is about telling with images, and that's what differs cinema from theater or from any other forms that they are like art forms. So I think directors, we cannot forget that. And many times directors forget that, and they just make movies that they're just talking heads. And many of those times they talk about things that we don't even care. So I think visual storytelling, it creates more like sensorial experience. When you watch a silent film, it really requires more attention from the audience. Sometimes it takes a few minutes to get into it, but once you get trapped, once you get in this kind of like trance, hypnotized by this succession of like images after images with the magic of music, because we cannot forget, even if we call it silent, in a way it's a musical film because the music is from beginning to end, the audience gets into this kind of magical, kind of like dream awake situation, and it becomes much more powerful. I can assure you that if the audience gets into a silent film, at the end of the screening, you know, the gratification is much stronger and much more intense than with a sound film. The shooting was extremely pleasurable. You know, it definitely the finance the film was 8 years, and definitely that was not pleasurable. That was really hard work. It was an obstacle after obstacle. And even I thought at some moment that maybe I was absolutely crazy, that I was never going to make a black and white silent movie and a very big budget movie, because Blancanieves is one of the biggest budget movies shot recently in Spain. But when after 8 years we got all the money ready and the finance started, it was amazing because I got the best possible crew. You know, Kiko de la Rica, director of photography, had worked with me in the past. He's one of the best director of photography of Spain. Alain Bainet, the art director, is one of the greatest. The costume designer, the actors, Maribel Verdú, Daniel Jiménez Cacho, Angela Molina. So in a way, I was like the team, the national, I made a national team of the best film people in Spain. And when we start shooting, you know, everybody was so happy to be, because this project was so different from anything that anybody had made before. We all felt we were doing something magical. And although it was very hot when we made the film, because we shot during the summer, and Madrid summers are hot, and when you're shooting in a bullfighting arena, sometimes we were under 40 degrees. So it was definitely the conditions. And shootings in general are hard, you know, you sleep very little, but we knew that we were doing something that it was out of the normal, so it was great. And also, as you said, you know, not only was pleasurable to make, I want to think that the movies is a pleasure to watch. You know, I think a movie like Blancanieves is more sensorial. And as you said, it has to do with the fact also that there's no dialogue. There's more space for the audience. I think a silent film sometimes is closer to like a vinyl, one of those old records that you would put over and over and over again. So I want to think that you can watch Blancanieves many times and you can see it and see different things. In a way, I think it's closer to like an opera or a ballet than it is to like what you call like a talkie, a sound film. Well, you know, it was funny because normally film festivals, you know, the screenings are much smaller, you know. Even if you consider the big screening, 400 people, and very normal there are 200, but when you get over 3,000 people, you know, you really don't feel like a film director, you feel like a rock star, you know, especially you go up some stairs and you have this big spot and, you know, people are clapping and they're like standing and, you know, it's a joy, you know, the only reason I make films is to connect, you know, it's a need, you know, because I write, direct and produce my films. Every film that I make is an act of love. And in a way, you know, the films don't belong to me. I really don't mind that I spent 8 years to make my film. But if the audience can spend 2 hours and forget about their problems and their lives, that's fantastic. I think film has some therapeutical idea. I think, you know, I don't want to, you know, in a way we are like film doctors. You know, I really like the idea that the audience forget about their lives and they enjoy a moment, you know, and forget about their problems. And to see 3,000 people at the same time sharing that moment, it was magical. You know, it was my first time in Sarajevo, and I'm very pleased that the festival chose Blancanieves to be part of this open air, because it has nothing to do, because also the quality of the sound was great, the projection was great. So, you know, it was very funny that when we got inside, they gave us some apple. So it was, you know, it was like very fun, unique. Let's put it this way, it would be unforgettable. It will stay for me forever. I will always remember when I screen Blancanieves at the Sarajevo Film Festival. I think that the word is vibrant. I feel it's vibrant. I think that it's alive. And sometimes the word film festival seems to think that you think about film buffs and guy with glasses and with bags and everybody's very serious. And that's not the image that the Sarajevo Film Festival. Sarajevo Film Festival has the idea of like, it's a young film festival, there's a talent campus, there are many unique films and there are people, and you know, to put 3,000 people in in my screening, but it was not only my screening at the same time. There were many screenings at the same time. It means that the film festival, it's really happening. And for a film director, we need that. We need to think there's an audience. And they, everybody told me that how big and how great was the Sarajevo Film Festival, but I didn't think it was going to be so amazing. And then it's amazing that after the screenings, the city is partying and having fun, and you know, it almost remind me to, you know, when I'm leaving Madrid, and it has that kind of, like, I felt like I was at home. I was in Spain, and I think it's, you know, the Sarajevo Film Festival has been like working with this way. I think it's really keep going up and up and up, like skyrocket.